Hello guys, this is Gazzard bringing you another ETS video. Now, this is a trip that I'm gonna take from... Let's just check the map. Of course, the map doesn't say anything. Liege, I think I pronounce it properly. From Liege, all the way through the through Luxembourg, Strasbourg, Zurich, up to Milano. It's a long trip, but I think we're gonna make it in, you know, one go. Well, this video will be divided into parts of 20 minutes. I just set up the clock and I'm gonna try to keep that time. So let's just start some lights so I know what I'm heading. Well, basically it's the start, the morning. I really appreciate that a lot of you actually are watching those videos. I thought that it's gonna be way... That guy headbeamed me that I can go, and then he went forward. Scumbag. Scumbag. I'm just gonna push my way through him then. What a scumbag. That's why I hate AI in this game, because they're ridiculously stupid. The only thing you can, you know, think of AI is that it's stupid. And I really am hoping that the patch that they will introduce will help with that, because honestly, I could have played this game even without AI. It would be way better without the AI traffic, because they're just simply too stupid. And they're always the boss, like this guy. They don't care that they're going from this road. No one cares. I have to stand in line. But yeah, going back to the topic. So we're back in our little Volvo FH16. Well, actually this isn't a 16, this is the FH13, properly called. With the 6x2 suspension. Meaning two of my axles are can traverse, and the most rear one is actually, you know, the one that gets power with the differential brake Actually feeling forced feedback at the moment. Go. It seems we're gonna be stuck in traffic for the first few minutes, and this is quite a long trip. Looking at the story, well, at the geoplanet, it's about 12 hours from what I remember. Yeah, 13 hours, so we're gonna have a rest stop in the meantime, but first we gotta get off this bloody city, and it just, the hopes of it. I'm actually very tempted now to go on the other lane and just, you know, go through all of them, because AI just takes such a ridiculously long time to do anything. But yeah, also I was wondering about a few things, because I'm gonna record this all in one go, like divide into parts of 20 minutes and render the footage at one day, and basically this whole trip will be a little bit different from what I'm used to doing, because you guys are gonna have all the content done, you know, like 2 weeks beforehand. But I think this is gonna be a 3-part video at the maximum. But I'm not certain about it, because if it's gonna be like this, we're already wasted a few minutes just standing here. Let me just check how much time we actually spent. Yeah, 5 minutes just standing here. You know what, I don't care for fucking red light offense, I'm not gonna stand there for the whole day. And of course you're gonna go here. Nope, nope, nope. Sorry about that, I'm trying to play this more like a sim, but... if I wanna make interesting videos and commentary, then I have to keep on moving, not stand in a place, because five fucking years I don't know what to do. So we're finally getting on the highway, and hopefully nothing will delay us anymore. Of course, now I won't get an excellent job bonus because I got crashed. But I crashed at the start because of that, you know, stupid eye that just driving straight in front of, straight in front of me. And that's the thing that pisses me the most in this game, you know? I can handle everything else, but AI? Nope. Just the fact what they do, what they tend to do, on average, is beyond, you know, my comprehension and my skills to even want to comprehend it. And as you can see, as in the last video, I'm not using the normal map, the GPS that you get on all trucks. I'm using the inbuilt in the truck GPS, because honestly I know most of the stuff beforehand when I start a trip. Like, I know my fuel, you know, I see my fuel usage, I see my speed, I see my gears, I see my revs, I see most of the things plus the GPS. The only thing I don't see is the fatigue, but yeah, I somehow will manage it, because you know, we'll have those signs that he starts yawning and stuff like that. And that's gonna be the point where we're gonna think like, ah, okay. But yeah, as I said, I want to get more into simulators, more into Sims. Not The Sims, Sims are simulator games. This is just a, you know, step in the right direction. I did a few videos, I think 3 videos total, from DCS A10 Warhawk and the Black Shark 2, from both from the same company. And I think I'm actually gonna make another video from that. I'm actually gonna try to make a full mission or even campaign playthrough in the DCS A10 Warhawk, because I'm the most familiar and the most I just feel good in the Hawk. I know what I can expect from the plane, and I know how to operate it to a certain degree. And I wanna use that experience to show you guys that, you know, you can accomplish something in your own. Maybe I'll get even some of you guys to start playing it. It's not that hard, honestly. Well, not that hard. Only a 700-page manual. Yeah, not that hard completely. Obviously. Liar. Because actually, if you guys are wondering what I'm doing in my free time, except for looking for a job and training for in capoeira, I'm actually learning all the procedures, key bindings and behavior of a typical A10 pilot to better simulate that in the game. Whoa, that guy is hauling some heavy duty equipment. Nice. Actually, this game is right now with other truck and trailers. Basically, it's only trailers, but we have 130 new trailers. If I will remember, I will put a link in the description of this and every next video with the link to the Modzaholic site, because those guys actually do those. As one of my drivers just made me some money, but I got my loan installment. I took a 400 euro loan to buy a garage, buy 2 trucks, you know, get drivers and stuff. And now I'm slowly paying it back. But honestly, if I have a good day, then my drivers, right now I have 3 drivers. My drivers pay the bills, you know, they pay the loan, so I can just not think about it and just keep on trucking, you know, keep on driving around, making videos for you guys, and like slowly expanding the company. I think my next garage will be in UK, and I will actually buy them proper UK trucks with, you know, the steering wheel on the other side, because I can't make myself drive one of those. I did back when I started playing GTS2, I did that because I needed, well, if I did a fast job and I had a country, city in England unlocked, if you took a job from that city, you had a left-hand drive car. So that's one of the reasons why I did it. That's some heavy load, he's gonna bump into me. Let's just give him some space, but honestly, I'm just gonna outspeed him. And he's going quite fast, 90 kilometers per hour, and he wants to overtake me. That's exactly what I mean with AI. And you know, I wouldn't be amazed if he just like switched the lane and hit me. I wouldn't be amazed at all. I got wars from AI, even in the start of this video, and I just repaired my track because I actually had a little bit of a derp moment last time streaming, and I inflicted a little bit of damage to the truck. We're going straight. Seems so. But yeah, like I said, I'm trying to get more into Sims. I'm probably when I'm gonna be able to, meaning when I get a job and after the first 2-3 paychecks, I'm gonna start to try to allocate my money in some decent gear for simulations, meaning a proper joystick. Well, maybe not a proper joystick, but a joystick, you know, because I have one, but it's a Logitech Wingman Attack 2, and it's actually broken. It's not that good, it's quite hard to operate, it's very stiff, per se, not that it's hard to move, but the movements, you can feel that it doesn't take into account the fluid, it doesn't make it fluid, it chops it up a little bit, and I actually have problems. Maybe that's gonna be one of the videos that I'm gonna make in the future, is how to set up your curves and dead zones and stuff like that, because that's quite actually important. My joystick has a lot of space that it freely moves around without actually, you know, giving input, without giving me any feedback. And that's just something like, if I put my hand on it, not even move it, it starts to twitch around, and if I'm flying IE-10 and that movement becomes, you know, becomes an input, then my plane is all over the place. So I had to neglect it. Also, like, you know, a very cheap joystick, it's a Tugmaster, a Logitech 3D one, I think that's what it's called. And it costs around 100 zloty, 120 zlotys, so it's around, divide that by 4, 40 euros, something like that, 40 euros let's say. So it's quite a cheap piece of equipment that you can use. And I think it's already has the qualities that I'm looking in for, you know, initial joystick, step-in joystick. I don't want to spend, you know, half of my paycheck for a proper joystick that I want. Even not, because I honestly, if I wanted to buy the joystick that I want, I would have to spend at least 2 of my paychecks. If I'm, you know, I'm guessing how much money I will get. But like, if it comes to the normal paychecks in Poland, then it would be somewhere around 1 or 1.5 paycheck. If you really good, you know, if you got a decent paycheck, normal paycheck, then it would be around 1, 1.5. The typical paycheck that I got, it would be somewhere around 2, and that's like spending all of the money that you get on that joystick. And it would be a hot ass Tugmaster 8N Warhawk joystick, because it's just such a sturdy joystick. It's made out of metal, it weighs around 4 kilograms, it has a metal base, it's a very good replica of the 8N Warhawk's joystick, of the actual plane joysticks and throttle. But it costs 2500 zlotys, I think, with the frost. So it's very expensive. I would want to spend quite a lot of money, you know, because I have to upgrade my whole equipment if I want to stay competitive in streaming and YouTubing, because it just, with this equipment, it takes so much time. I really am spending 2 or 3 days doing videos, not doing anything else but videos. I spend my mornings doing videos or searching for jobs, going, you know, with my CVs and stuff like that. But just getting the proper equipment to make YouTube a more viable source, a more viable hobby per se, maybe like that, because not a source of money, because it's gonna be a long time since I'm gonna till I'm gonna make money out of YouTube. Because even like the fact And there's a big shout out for Rita actually with this, because she's actually the reason. Most of the time my videos, like after even a year, because now I'm getting to almost a year in streaming, above a year. Most of my videos don't exceed 200 views, and that's like videos that I, you know, myself posted on the World of Tanks forums, my World of Tanks videos, the best reviews and stuff like that. They get around 200 viewers, you know. I didn't get jack shit. I didn't get even a penny out of any of that. And actually last week we posted a video from Scrappy Coco, the video where he played his Hellcat. The fact that Rita liked the video on her Twitter made it so right now, and this is I'm recording this on Friday, right now that video has around 560 views. Meaning it exceeded three times as almost three times as much views as my normal videos. So that's also a big help. Maybe some of those people actually stay on my channel and will watch more of my videos. I don't know. Guessingly not, because it's World of Tanks and I'm gonna focus on content that is completely different from World of Tanks and from the typical World of Tanks. Not interesting for the typical World of Tank player. But we'll see how it goes. So we got a little bit of time left, I think 2 or 3 minutes. You can see he's just riding on the highway, stalking. Basically, that's what Euro Truck's videos are. You talk about a lot of things, like mods that's gonna come out, mods that you use, mods that are gonna come out, and stuff like that. And I think that's great, because in World of Tanks, most of the time I was just, you know, I just had to do the voiceover over the video, and that was about it. I didn't have the time to talk to my viewers. But now, since I'm doing this, I actually have some time to speak to my viewers. Tall boots, love him. Go go truck. This isn't the most powerful engine for this truck, but I'm not gonna play with the most powerful engine unless I get some kind of a push towards it. Let me just check the time, bro. 2 minutes. So yeah, I'm gonna need a push towards it, and I don't mean you guys, but like I mean the fact that like I'm gonna have trailers that weigh above 30 tons. That would actually make me think of a bigger engine. Because right now I don't see a direct gain from going up an engine. It basically uses more fuel, and that's about it. So I wouldn't say it's a very good thing, or rather a very bad thing, to be frankly honest. But yeah, I know that a lot of people just buy the biggest engines because I can, and I understand the logic completely. I did it myself, but now I try to play a little bit more sim-like. Yeah, I said after, in the beginning of the video, he rams people out of the road. Yeah. And I, honestly, if I wanted to play this completely sim-like, I would have to drive with an automatic gearbox, because in normal truck drivers, you know, not the new trucks like this, this is the 2012 version of this truck. So it's only 2 years at the moment. Those trucks all have automatic gearboxes. You don't need a manual gearbox. Maybe a semi-automatic gearbox, but certainly not a full manual one. Like we are operating right now, you know, I'm switching the gears all the time with my joystick. You know, one down, one up. Basically, when I'm starting the truck, I start it always in the second gear, then go on to 4, 6, 8, and then I start to go by ones, mainly because that's the best power ratios that I can do, you know. Because if I didn't do that, if I didn't skip gears, I would just be constantly switching gears in the lower revs, and it's quite annoying and time consuming. NAI proves to stop, because No, there's no particular reason why, just because. But yeah, let's cut this video around here. Yep, exactly 20 minutes. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. And I'll see you guys basically next time in... Well, on the roads, on the battlefield.